Hopefully, by now, all of us have understood the phenomena of the light, that is the continuous sunlight during the summer months in Antarctica and the continuous period of darkness during the winter months and the reason behind. If not, please type your answers in the comment section in the GCR. I will definitely help you out with all your queries. Next important phenomena we really need to know about is that is why the South Pole is colder than the North Pole, whereas both of them are in the frigid zone. Both of them, that is the North Pole, is located at an angular distance of 90 degrees north of the equator, whereas the South Pole, it is located at an angular distance of 90 degrees south of the equator. Location is also the same, the zone is also the same, that is the frigid zone. Still, the South Pole is colder than the North Pole. Let us find out the reasons behind it. Here we need to understand that the South Pole has Antarctica as a landmass. That means the point of the South Pole, around all of it, you have the continent of Antarctica. Here, you can see it in this map. Here you have the South Pole, around which you have your entire continent of Antarctica. That is a landmass. Whereas the North Pole, that is the 90 degree location of the North Pole in the northern hemisphere, that is located in the Arctic Ocean. That is a water body. So where do we have Antarctica? That is around the South Pole. And around the North Pole, what do we have? We have water. Around the South Pole, we have land, and around the North Pole, we have water. Very simple difference. So, one reason behind. Now, what is the difference between the properties of land and water that we have already learned previously? Since class 3, we have been learning about the phenomena of the land breeze and the sea breeze. So, here the same, approximately the same concept applies, where we understand that the land heats up and cools faster than water. Therefore, when we are experiencing the same phenomena in the South Pole, that is Antarctica, it will remain cooler for a longer period of time. So here at the North Pole, the Arctic Ocean is also very cold and has layers of ice on the ocean surface, but the land heats and cools faster than water. Therefore, we have the South Pole where we have the land mass. It will continue to stay colder because it is continuously being surrounded by ice. You have heard, you've learned about the entire content of ice on top of Antarctica. That is approximately 2,200 meter thick. So the landmass is below that much of us ice. So the main reason why Antarctica is colder than the Arctic area, that is the North Pole area, that it is surrounded by the North Pole is surrounded by the water body, whereas in the South Pole you have the landmass of Antarctica, which is piled up with 2,200 meters of thick ice, which reflect the rays of the sun and do not allow the heat to be absorbed by the land content, which is completely piled up with so much of ice. So here the South Pole is colder than the North Pole. And this entire phenomena we had learnt while we were doing the land and sea breeze, and we've been continuously doing this since class 3. So there's nothing more difficult about it. We experience this very, very clearly. The sea breeze during the day, where the land heats up faster. Therefore, the warm air is around the land, which it goes towards the sea. And during night, also, the cool air is around your land because it has cooled up faster. So it runs to take the place of the warm air or the low pressure, which is created by the warm air, which rises continuously. Therefore, we have the cool breeze taking its place and creating an equilibrium in it. Here is a
comparison. Difference between Arctic and Antarctic regions. Arctic region is on the northern pole of the Earth. Antarctic region is on the southern pole of the Earth. Arctic region is ocean at center and surrounded by lands. Antarctic region is mainly on a continent, it is surrounded by ocean. Arctic comprises of Arctic Ocean, Russia, Sweden, Norway, Iceland, Finland, Greenland, Canada, and Alaska. Antarctic comprises of continent Antarctica and nearby ocean region and island. Most of the Arctic are at sea level as major part of Arctic are on Arctic Ocean. Antarctic region are at an average height of over 2,200 meter above the sea level. Because of warm ocean currents, the Arctic is warmer with winter temperature ranging from minus 43 degrees Celsius to minus 26 degrees Celsius. Antarctic region being very high above sea level have low temperature with winter temperature ranging from minus 62 degrees Celsius to minus 55 degrees Celsius. Highest recorded temperature in the region is plus 5 degrees Celsius. Highest recorded temperature in the region is around minus 13 degrees Celsius. Coldest temperature was minus 89.2 degrees. Arctic is home to many kind of animals like polar bears, wolf, walrus, owls, etc. Antarctic is home to animals like penguins, seals, whales, albatrosses, etc. Arctic has a human population of 4 million. Antarctic has no human settlement apart from presence of scientists and tourists in summer and even less in winter. Ice cover in Arctic region varies depending on the season. It recedes from land regions in summer. In Antarctic, around 1% of land is visible and rest of regions are permanently under the ice sheets. Please support by sharing and subscribing. Thanks for watching.
Let us proceed further with the vegetation. That is, very few plants grow in Antarctica because of the ice cover and the harsh climate. The most common plants which are found out there are the mosses and lichens, and these plants cling on to the rocky area, mostly along the coast. And some clumps of coarse grass and flowering plants are also found where the temperatures are a little mild. That is also along the coastal area. Here, very clearly, we understand three facts: that why is there very little vegetation, or why there are no trees or bushes in the Antarctica area. Number one, it is covered with snow. Number two, very little exposed rock surface is there. Number three, there is no rainfall or water out there. So these three are the basic factors which lead to very less vegetation, or the vegetation in the form of only mosses, lichens and algae. Number one, that is the mosses, and there are only two types of mosses plants that are found out there along the coastal region of Antarctic Peninsula. And now we need to revise, where is Antarctic Peninsula? It is in the West Antarctic area. Now these are your hair grass and the pearlwort. These are the plants or the categories of the mosses which are found along the coast, because they also need water to survive. So in summer, when the ice thaws or the melts, we can have a little bit of water which is actually required for the growth of mosses. And on the rocky area, as you can see in the picture also, on top of the rocks, these moss grows. Same for the second category also, that is the lichens, that there are three main types of lichens out there. The names have been given to you, and you can see in the picture that they are growing or basically just clinging on to the surface area. Now wherever you find surface, there only you will have some kind of a plant growth or a root which can continue to grow. So here these are all the three types of lichens. Third one is the algae, the third category of vegetation, and Antarctica is home to very many types of algae, and here you have a number, that is 1600 separate types of green algae is only found. So here the first picture shows your red algae, green algae and ice algae. Sometimes in the YouTube or Instagram or any of the social sites, you must have seen that the entire ice of the Antarctica has turned red or it has turned green. They try to just create interest of the viewer by just saying that it is red ice all over the Antarctica. It's nothing but the growth of either of the types of algae, that is either the red algae, green algae or the ice algae. If you just zoom into these pictures, you can clearly see them very well growing onto the rock surface and on top of the ice also. So now if you have some vegetation in the area or in the continent, you will definitely have some kind of animal life also which will survive on these vegetation. So here in Antarctica, you have very few insects and some tiny animals are found in Antarctica. Although it is the land of ice, but the ocean has plenty of wildlife. And many warm-blooded animals live in the water or along the coast. So there you can find a little wildlife, specifically the birds. And birds and seals mostly live near the edges of the continent. This can also come as a give reason question as to why they are surviving out there. Because number one, they get food in form of the other insects or the krill that they found in the ocean water, or the plants which we've already discussed, that is the mosses, lichens and the algae. They can feed onto them. And secondly, they live along the ocean coast or the coastline to avoid the freezing temperature which is there in the center of the continent. So you can have two answers to that give reason question as to why do we find wildlife along the edges of the continent of Antarctica. And while explaining these 40 kinds of birds that are living along the water or the coastline, you have the major ones which have been mentioned here: the albatross, prions, gulls, cormorants, petrels. And here all of them are in order only: albatross, prions, gulls, cormorants and petrels. We will continue with the wildlife in the next class. There are two beautiful poems which I'm leaving you with. That is on the penguins. Hopefully you'll read them so we can continue with the discussion of the most important bird of Antarctica, with which Antarctica is mostly associated also. And we'll continue with the class next time. Thank you.